Today, let's learn about the transform origin property. The transform origin property is used along with the transform property. For example, we can see here transform rotate Z 30 degrees and transform origin top. Here, the point of transformation or rotation starts from the top center. If you want to keep the transform origin at the center, then there is no need to use the transform origin property. This is because the transform origin is at the center by default. However, if you want to shift your transform origin, then you have to use it. The CSS property transform origin defines the point around which a transformation is applied to an element. It is the point or origin of the transform property, which can change the point of transformations like rotation, scaling, skewing, etc. By default, the transform origin of an element is relative to the center of an element. If we set here transform origin bottom, then the transform origin is at the bottom center. Similarly, you can set to left, next, right, let's set to right top.
Here the transform origin has shifted to the top right corner.
You can also set the transform origin value such as left top, left bottom, right bottom, and so on. Okay guys, I'll show you some more examples. Instead of using transform origin right bottom, we can use transform origin 100%. Here the first value is x and the second value is y. Both x and y move 100% away from zero, intersecting at the right bottom corner. So transform origin 100% is same as transform origin right bottom. Here 50% represents the x value. Even though nothing is mentioned for y, it still means that the y value is 50% by default. In this case, we find that both the x and y values are each specified as 50%. Here the x value is 50% and the y value is 0, which sets the transform origin to the top center. Here are some examples of transform origin values that give the same effects. Please go through all of these. This is the main syntax for transform origin values. We have x offset value, which defines the horizontal position of the origin. The second one is y offset value, which defines the vertical position of the origin. And the third is z offset value, which defines the position along the z axis when using 3D transformations. Transform origin can be a one value syntax, two value syntax, and three value syntax. The three value syntax can be used specially in a 3D element. Here are examples of one value syntax, two value syntax, and three value syntax. Please go through all of these. Please note that the Z offset cannot be used in percentage because there is no measurable or clear size on the Z axis. We can also use global values in transform origin. Here we have global values, transform origin inherit, transform origin initial, transform origin revert, transform origin revert layer, and transform origin unset. In CSS, global values control how properties are applied or reset by inheriting values, using default settings or reverting to previous or default states. So in conclusion, the transform origin is very useful when we animate or style our transformations. By changing the transform origin, we can make the visual effect of an element look much better. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like this video, and also please don't forget to check our other videos. Bye for now, until next time.